Over the next four lessons, we'll discuss two very important problems: finding a maximum flow in a graph and solving a linear programming optimization. These problems are p-complete, meaning that any problem that can be solved on a Turing machine in polynomial time can be turned into one of these problems. We will also see an important restricted case in the bipartite matching problem, and then we'll explore the connections among all these problems in a discussion of the principle of duality, which is the inspiration for a large class of approximation algorithms. In this first lesson, we discuss the problem of finding a maximum flow through a network. A network here is essentially anything that can be modeled as a directed graph. And by flow, we mean the movement of some stuff through a medium, from some designated source to a destination. Typically, we want to maximize the flow. That is to say, we want to route as many packets as possible from one computer across a network to another, or we want to ship as many items from our factories to our stores. Even if we don't actually want to move as much as possible across the network, understanding the maximum flow can give us important information. For instance, in communication networks, it tells us something about how robust we are to link failures. And even more abstractly, maximum flow problems can help us figure out things that seem unrelated to networks, like which teams have been eliminated from playoff contention in sports. Given the variety and importance of these applications, it should be no surprise that maximum flow problems have been studied extensively, and we have some sophisticated and elegant algorithms for solving them. Let's dive in.